오늘의 환상 특급은 인생을 건 위험한 치료에 나선 한 환자의 병실에서 시작됩니다.
Can you sleeping medicine, honey?
Is it night already?
It's
9:30. Was it a beautiful day?
It was kind of warm.
Yes. When will they take the bandages off?
Until they decide whether or not they can fix your face.
Pretty bad, isn't it?
I've seen worse.
Ever since I was a little girl, people have turned away when they looked at me. I never really wanted to be beautiful. I just wanted people not to scream when they looked at me. When will I take the bandages off?
Maybe tomorrow. Maybe the next day. Ever see your face, 307? If it were mine, I'd bury myself in a grave someplace.
Your introduction to Miss Janet Tyler, who lives in a very private world of darkness. A universe whose dimensions are the size, thickness, length of a swath of bandages that cover her face. And this patient, 307, is not just a woman. This happens to be the Twilight Zone.
You'll have those bandages off you very soon. I expect you're pretty uncomfortable.
I think I've lived my whole life inside of a dark cave. The walls are gauze. It's hopeless, isn't it, Doctor?
Well, that's hard to say. You haven't responded to the shots or the medications. However, we're very hopeful for what this last treatment may have accomplished. There's no telling, of course, till we get the bandages off. Your 11th visit.
No more after this, are they, Doctor?
11 is the mandatory number of experiments.
And if I haven't responded, then what?
Well, there are alternatives. Don't you know?
Yes, I know. Doctor. May I walk outside and sit in the garden just to make believe I am normal? Grotesque. Ugly woman with a bandage on her face. Please help me.
There are many others who share your misfortune. People who look much as you do. One of the alternatives, just in the event that this last treatment is not successful, this is simply to allow you to move into a special area in which people of your kind have been congregated.
Oh, you mean segregated? Ghetto designed for freaks!
Miss Tyler! It's doing all it can for you. Now, you know you can't expect to live any kind of a life among normal people.
I could try. The state isn't God, Doctor. The state is not God! It hasn't the right to penalize somebody for an accident of birth. It hasn't the right to make ugliness a crime!
Miss Tyler, stop this immediately.
Please take this off me, please. Take it off me!
You look tired, Doctor. I know how much it means to you, this case in 307.
As you do everything medically possible, and then in the end, you cross your fingers and you hope for a miracle. You see, Nurse, I've looked underneath those bandages.
So have I. It's horrible.
I've seen that woman's real face, Nurse. It's a human face.
It's easier for me to think of her as human when her face is covered up.
What is the dimensional difference between beauty and something repellent? Why shouldn't people be allowed to be different? Why?
Doctor, careful what you're talking about.
I know, treason. Don't be concerned, Nurse. I'll be all right once the bandages are off, once I know one way or the other.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, I shall talk to you about the ultimate pleasure of our unified society.
I'm going to cut the bandages a section at a time, then I'm going to unwrap the bandages. Process has to be slow so that your eyes can become accustomed to the light. As you know, these injections may have had some effect on your vision.
I understand.
Look up toward the light. How about now, Miss Tyler?
It's very bright.
Good, good. I'm at the last layer of bandages, Miss Tyler. Now we have done all we could do. Please remember, Miss Tyler, that you can still live a long and fruitful life among people of your own kind.
If I'm still terribly ugly, is there any other alternative? Could I please be put away?
I doubt very much whether we would be permitted to do anything but transfer you to a communal group of people with your disability.
You'll make me go then.
That would probably be the case. I wish you every good luck. No change. No change at all. Needle, please.
there must be a single purpose, a single norm, a single approach, a single morality, a single philosophy of government. Different us, wicked us, turning into destroyers is the key to survival.
Miss Tyler, don't be afraid. He's only a representative from the group you're going to live with. Now, this is Mr. Smith. He'll take you there tonight. It's the only way now.
Miss Tyler, I think you're going to like it where I'm going to take you.
Why do we have to look like this?
I don't know, Miss Tyler. I really don't know. But you know something? It doesn't matter. There's an old saying. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
Goodbye, Miss Tyler.
Where is this place and when is it? What kind of world where ugliness is the norm and beauty the deviation from that norm? The answer is, it doesn't make any difference. In this year or 100 years hence, on this planet or wherever there is human life, perhaps out amongst the stars, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Lesson to be learned in the Twilight Zone.
오늘 소개해드린 에피소드는 60년대 제작된 환상특급 시리즈 중에서 IMDb 평점이 가장 높은 에피였습니다. 저도 아주 재미있게 감상했는데요. 초중반까지 얼굴 전체에 붕대를 감은 여인이 나타나 계속 궁금증을 자아내기도 하고 뭔가 미스터리한 분위기에 그로테스크한 이미지가 약간 공포스러운 느낌까지 주는데요. 마지막에 아주 굵고 선명한 반전으로 스토리를 마무리한 꽤 잘 만들어진 미스터리 에피였습니다. 각자의 차별성과 편견, 동일성을 강조하는 체제에 대한 고찰을 해볼 수 있는 의미 있는 메시지도 참 좋았고요. 영상 제작에 큰 힘이 되는 구독, 좋아요, 댓글 부탁드릴게요.